There's nothing more exciting than science. You get all the fun of sitting still, being quiet, writing down numbers, paying attention. Science has it all.
Earlier this year, a kilometer-wide asteroid came hurtling towards the Earth at more than 34,000 miles per hour and passing within the moon's orbit. Luckily, we were never in any real danger. The object, nicknamed PZ-39, has been on NASA's radar, both metaphorically and literally, since way back in 2002. It's just one of the more than 20,000 near-Earth asteroids they monitor. Since there aren't many forces acting on objects in space, asteroids are as close as you can get to those with no friction or air resistance high school physics problems, and so we can usually track these near-Earth asteroid orbits fairly accurately, years or even decades in advance. But here's an interesting question. What if back in 2002, NASA realized PZ-39 was on a direct collision course with Earth? With more than a decade to prepare, how would NASA try to stop a rogue asteroid? If you love watching our videos and learning new things, be sure to check out our Discord, link in the description below. And let's jump in. In the movies, you often see the US launching a nuclear bomb at an incoming asteroid, usually to blow it to bits. The one problem with that, if you blow it to bits, some of those bits may still be hurtling in our direction. But don't worry, NASA has a few more sophisticated ideas up their sleeves. Instead of hitting the asteroid with something as big as a nuke, NASA likes the idea of something a bit more precise. Enter NASA's kinetic impactor, which would deflect an incoming asteroid by smacking into it. Like pushing someone on skates, the idea is to hit the asteroid just barely hard enough to nudge it off course, but not hard enough to fracture it. If we detect the asteroid 20 years in advance, like we did with PZ, slowing the asteroid by only 1 mile an hour, or 1.6 kilometers an hour, would be enough to divert it by more than 150,000 miles. Up next, coming straight out of a cartoon, what if we shot it with a net? When NASA detects an asteroid, it's not like they have a 4K image of it. Our resolution from millions of miles away might literally just be a blip on a screen. NASA expects that many asteroids are really clusters of asteroids that were pulled together by their weak gravitational force. And since the asteroids don't have enough gravitational force to actually merge into one object, they could literally just be two asteroids holding hands drifting through space together. So if we tried a kinetic bombardment on what we thought was one asteroid, we might divert one of the smaller asteroids while keeping the rest hurtling towards us. Their solution to get around this? Shoot a net first, ask questions later. NASA scientists think that a carbon fiber mesh weighing somewhere in the neighborhood of 550 pounds or 250 kilograms could be enough to change an asteroid's incoming course. But if the asteroids are too big, the logistics of using a net just don't work out. If you're interested in knowing just how large these asteroids can get, check out this video on the largest things in the universe after this one. But we don't have to touch an asteroid in order to deflect it. If we could put a satellite in orbit around the asteroid, we would have a few options. If the satellite was fitted with lasers, it could heat a small portion of the asteroid's surface, vaporizing it. As the material ejects from the asteroid, it would provide just enough thrust to alter the asteroid's path. Even without the laser, if the asteroid was small enough, the satellite's gravitational pull alone could be enough to pull the asteroid off course. The last and probably weirdest idea we'll discuss today is to eat the asteroid. The NASA-funded Modular Asteroid Deflection Mission Ejector Node Project, aka Mad Men, involves sending nuclear-powered robots to a threatening asteroid, where they'd land and begin mining or chewing into the surface of the rock. They would then eject these fragments into space with the help of electromagnets. And as Newton told us, every action has an equal and opposite reaction. So by ejecting small pieces of the asteroid, you could provide enough force to nudge it off course. So rest assured, while we're watching YouTube and clicking that like button, NASA is hard at work trying to keep us from going the way of the dinosaurs. If you liked the video, be sure to leave a like and a comment. The analytics really do help us small channels, and who doesn't want to watch a small science channel grow? And if you never want to miss an upload, don't forget to subscribe. As always, have a great day, and remember, there is always more to learn.